models. One is German, Bulldog. The second is Italian, Bergami. And the third one is Intema, Turkish. And we will figure out what are the differences, what are the details, and what is the segments of all these kitchens. Let's start from Bulldog. Bulldog kitchen is one of the best kitchens in the world. Why it's one of the best kitchens? Because as you see, it's very linear, so much basic, so much simple. But why? The thing matters here is the details, installation, materials, and how it's built. Let's start from the beginning. Here, as you see, in the cupboards, generally in Turkey we are using 18 millimeter, but here they use 13 millimeter in the top and 10 millimeter in the sides. So you may ask, what is the deal with it? The deal is the nail you are using. If you are using short nail, then the door can turn. If you are using the long one, it may go out. So what Bulldog did is they sold their own detail and they took the patent of it. That's why they sold it, they made it very, very thin, easy to use. And here, every drawer, they have a special kind of mat. It's like a silicone, so nothing is leaving trace to the furniture and nothing is slipping. And as a detail here, you see they have their own special details. When you close the door to the main structure, it has its own stopper and a hidden drawer. Okay. Here, as you see, as I told you before, all the detail, all the drawers has the same detail, same mat. So you don't have to do special thing to cover it. And the second one with like push and pull. Let's see what they think about inside. As you see, they have their different storage units. These are for spices. They have their own line, own brand everywhere, in every their design. Here they have with special leather, real leather units. You can put your stuff here. And for knives, they have special units. So what is here is less is more. They have less, but as a quality they have more. What they're obsessed about is horizontal lines. They don't like vertical ones. You cannot convince this company to use these handles vertically. They don't let you. They are all in there. Sheets or cooking sheets, you have special units. It's all their design. It's kind of perfect. Another very important thing about Bulldog kitchen. As you see, they don't have any details on the doors, and you cannot have it. You cannot have any detail, any movement in any part here. They just let you select the different colors, different materials, different coatings, but not the design. Design is this, agree or not, they don't change. And what is good about this company? Of course, you don't have to buy the countertop from here. You may buy, this is the aluminum version. There is other versions like laminate, then there is lacquer, matte, shiny. They are providing them. Or you can select in another company some other countertop. But the important thing is here, generally, no wall is in the perfect condition. So what Bulldog is doing? They have a flying kitchen. Flying kitchen means here, they have 25 centimeter space from the floor, and it's very hard to fix this furniture here with this much like empty space on it. How they do it? Utah is always doing their own construction at the wall. So what they are doing? They are making the first wall construction, and they are making all this thing, all this furniture carried by this construction. So they give you 100% guarantee that nothing will happen to this countertop, to this units. It's under their guarantee. And they don't sell this kitchen without this construction.
What is good about this, another thing, advantage about this, is when you are doing the cupboards of the kitchen, first you do them, then another company, or the same company who is doing the countertop, is coming and taking dimensions to cut the countertop. Here you don't have any problem like that. Because of this structure, you have fixed size. So you are not no longer affected by the diffusions in the wall. So you can order your countertop when you're ordering your kitchen at the same time. There is no problem about that. About the islands, there is no need of this construction. They suggested always to fix it, but it's your preference to take it or not. So another thing I want to tell you, they don't have like a regular polishing system. They have very different, very interesting polishing system. As you see here, I'm touching it a lot, and you can never see no longer my fingerprints here. Let's see more details. Everything is solid here. Let's see the other part of this kitchen. Kitchen is like a place. It's just a unique piece. Like you cannot do different designs. Yes, you may do, but in Bhutan, you cannot. You need to follow the same lines. As you see here, they did again this construction, and they have this metal shelves, and under it there is lighting. Again, everything is, as you see, horizontal lines, big lines, big units. They are providing you a lot of color choices, countertop choices. Like you can play with it, you can choose different colors, you can use different textures, but only the ones that they are proposing you, not the thing that you like. Here, it seems like a wall, right? But guess what? What it may be? It's a refrigerator. Look at this finishing. How they fixed it. How they fixed it all together. And 7th was Gaggenau. So, Bhutan has 3 types of kitchen. B1, B2 and B3. Here, B1 is not existing. Let me show you. I introduced you B3. Let's see how it is like B2. B2 is a modular kitchen, which is convenient for small spaces, who are students, or who are living in rental places. Because you can really pack up your kitchen. You can close it and take it to the room where you cook. So, talk about everything. In the island, you have the cooking pot, you have your units. And the door is what you can need from the kitchen. your pots, your knives, your cooking tools, everything is compact. It may seem more basic version, but the quality is the same, so price is not differing a lot. Again, this brand is even in Germany in a very high segment. Even with 35% of German people are knowing and using this kind of kitchen. So it's really quite high price, quite high finishing, the best kitchen. Now we are in an Italian kitchen. Let's see the details of the kitchen. As you see, contrary to the German kitchen, it has a very classic approach in every detail. As you see here, in the cupboard doors, handles, everything is more classic. It's a bit like a country style, I can say. Details here is completely different from the drying kitchen. Here you can see the drying unit. And here they use the countertop from the brand Franke, which is acrylic, which is Korean. So what is the advantage of this kind of countertop? The advantage here is that you can see the lines where the pots are combined with each other, because they have special coating system that is covering, and this is very easy to use but a bit expensive and healthy also. And the thing about Barloni is that they are giving a name to each their kitchen style. They are generally using cities in Italy, but this one is named as Atena. And all this kitchen has some special concept in detail from this name. For example, the columns in Atena. Imagine that. And you see here, the small details are reminding us the city. This is a volcanic style of sink, which is a bit maybe exaggerated, big and high, but it's from the same brand. It's a volcanic stone and it's quite nice, the details. It's really, really a big stone and it's getting out from the furniture. But you don't have to use the same countertop that this company is suggesting you. You can always choose another countertop, or you can always choose another kitchen appliances or sinks, whatever. It's your choice, your combination. This is just for a show here. Of course, Barloni is one of the best classic kitchen makers in the world, but they are also good at combining the classic with the modern approach. Before seeing the modern version of Barloni, I would like to suggest you some other brands that I like so much with Barloni kitchens. Let's see that. What I was suggesting you was, of course, Meng. With its same approach as classic and modern at the same time, and always special in every time, this Meng brand is getting along very good with Barloni classic kitchen. Not only the refrigerator, but also the kitchen part, the cooktop, and the oven. It's a multiple unit, but it's very, very nice with Barloni kitchen. If you are seeking for a more vintage, more country style, you should consider Barloni with Smeg. Together they are perfect. Modern version of Barloni. Here, let's see
from the details. They have their own handles here, there is a lab. And to have this effect, they use real wood, not MDF. Because even though it's like mentioned as a more modern version, but it is the modern version of Bernoulli, not your modern version or not a German modern version. Their modern is this. And as you see, inside of the drawers, there is always this leather, which is very nice. And very useful, by the way, to use more. Because when you are buying a kitchen, it's suggested at least 15 or 20 years of use. And these companies are giving you this opportunity, this long-term use opportunity. And as in the German brand, here also they are using their own hardware, their own details. And even though they are using the single surface, they are giving it some movements with special coating, special materials. And as in the classic version, Smeg also have modern approach here. And this is also a different material for the kitchen countertop. It's a quartz material. Before passing to another kitchen, I would like to talk with you about some countertop materials. Of course, for countertop, you can use aluminum, you can use wood, you can use marble, granite, a lot of different kinds of materials. But here I'm showing you the quartzite materials, which is made up of some chemicals plus the powder of quartz. Here there is a company from Spain which is called Southbomb. These are their products. And this is the Turkish one from Manisa, and there is another one from Izmir which is called Chimson. And from Manisa, this one is called Belenko. And the difference between them is the amount of quartzite or the type of quartzite they are using that is giving it different kind of texture, different kind of color. The only difference is this. The only difference. Has a lot of defects over it, but imagine it as a surface, countertop surface for all your kitchen. It is very, very hard to take care of. Kitchen is where our reflexes are on the top. You are cooking something while you are putting on the countertop, it's very hot, you just drop it. For other kind of surfaces, you can do that, but for wood, you can burn the wood and you cannot take it back. So it's very fragile. So if you're active about the kitchen, you shouldn't use wooden countertop. Okay, now let's talk about Turkish kitchens. This kitchen is designed as a prototype. It's not for sale now, but it's quite interesting and quite nice kitchen. I would like to introduce you. Let's see how Turkish people are doing kitchen. So, the main property of this kitchen is it's not made up of MDF or other things, as it's always done. It's from Contraflux, which is bring together and coated. And guess what? It's not only for drawers or cupboards, it's for whole body. The same approach is continuing and it's giving it a very natural, very nice texture. And here the designer also think about the fresh vegetables and fruits. There is traditional palettes here for this kind of fresh products. And as you see, they don't use a lot of different colors or textures. There's natural wood and single color. And I would like to introduce you that as you see, the height of these units are so much natural, like in my height, something like 165. And there is this unit, it's very easy to use because it's not so much high, not so much down. I don't have to get down or stand up. And here everything is organized perfectly. And as you see in the details, it's like Italian and German kitchens. They have special kind of mat and the details are very well finished. And there is this glass separator, which is polished marble, and it's giving a nice effect on the front. And there is also some vertical units with a lot of storage area. So if you once come to Istanbul, you can only try this prototype. Unfortunately, you cannot buy, but it's always open for trials for different events or your personal cooking experience. You can always come here and try this. Now I'm gonna introduce you the Turkish kitchen brand, which is called Inkema. Inkema is doing different kind of kitchens from classic to modern. This is an example of the classic one. So let's see. As it seems from far, it seems like lacquer, matte lacquer surface, but it's not like that. It's a special coating system they are using, which is with vacuum. It's capturing all the corners so you don't see any lines in the connection points. And as Italian kitchen, they have details a lot with CNC. And they have handles very detailed. And for this kind of kitchen, they used a vintage version of Franke kitchen appliances. And I think it's quite nice. And here inside, there is a classical separation system. The other ones, which are coated, inside there is always single same material, either white or cream. That's where we are understanding that they are coated. Here, they coated inside exactly the same material. But inside color is always the same, light color. And as a surface, here, they use different kind of ceramics. Ceramic is also a nice choice, it's a healthy choice for the kitchen countertop. So, in this video, we tried to introduce you different kitchens from Germany, from Italy, and from Turkey. And we tried to explain you what makes them this much different and what raised the price segments in kitchen design industry. So, if you like this video and you want us to do this kind of videos, please like this video and follow our channel. I was about to forget. Please tell me which is your favorite kitchen down below in the comments.